Flandered fields the poppies blow, between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky the larks still bravely singing fly scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead, short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flandered fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw a torch, be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in the Flandered fields.
Where the angels learn to fly. love him so.
Tell him we will meet again
where the angels fly to fly.
My name is Julio Duor. I'm an eighth grader at Cumberland Middle School, and I wrote an essay for Patriots Pen titled, What Does Patriotism Mean to Me? I hear the loud fireworks shoot out of the sky, colors like a glimpse of the spotlight. The loud rattles fill the ears of hundreds of millions of Americans. Patriotism, a word of national pride and love, a word of devotion for our country, rich with history and diversity. What does it mean to be patriotic? To be patriotic. How to be patriotic? Well, patriots show support to the ones that fight for this country, like veterans and people that are on active duty. If they weren't here, there'd be no country to be patriotic for. Another way to be patriotic is to learn the country's history. There's been some good and some bad things in our country's past, so it's good to appreciate our benefits that we have now and learn from our mistakes. Keeping our country intact and welcome is another way to be patriotic. You could volunteer for things to help our community, whether it's picking up garbage at our beaches or planting saplings for our native animals who've lost their homes. Or you could throw organizations that are helping to make our country great. There's many things that you can do for this land which we call home. And even if this country has many flaws, there's still many beautiful things about it that we can appreciate and show pride for. This country has been through a lot to be the way it is today. We should appreciate the things that make it unique. You can have two people in the same room and they all have different histories and backgrounds. That's what makes our country so great. Our differences benefit each other. So we should embrace our culture and appreciate others as well. Now for the grand finale. The final fireworks reaches higher than any other. It touches its peak. I hear the short sizzle as millions of sparks fall down and the people cheer. How patriotism means to me is to support the ones who make this country the way it is. Patriotism consists not in waving the flag, but in striving that our country shall be righteous as well as strong, a quote by James Bryce. The sparks drip down from the sky. You can see the evidence of the fog from its bright stars. I can't wait for next year, I smile to myself.
Hello, my name is Ben Cunningham, and this is my VFW Patriots Pen essay. The prompt for this essay was, is this the country that the Founding Fathers envisioned? I think that this is the country that the Founding Fathers would have wanted. We still have traditions and ideas that have been preserved from their time. We have also put their ideas into place. They wanted a Western expansion, and we did that. We have united the country from sea to shining sea. Now Americans have the same rights and even more. Now every person is free of slavery. That was abolished in the 13th Amendment. A lot of people were given citizenship at that time, too. The idea of westward expansion was envisioned by the Founding Fathers. We have done that now. They would have liked how we did it, even though it was wrong. They still viewed the natives in a negative way back then. The Founding Fathers would have been proud of what we'd done to North America. We have two borders on oceans. Only a couple other countries have that. The United States was built on the premise of all men being created equal. At that time, it wasn't true. The Founding Fathers envisioned that, and now it has come true. The government still has preserved rights that we had then. Americans have also gained a few. Now all people have the right to vote. They would have been proud of what we had done with the rights. Back then, there were still slaves, too. Now they are freed. They got freed in the 13th Amendment. People that were born in America gained citizenship in the 14th, and citizens got to vote in the 15th. The 15th did not include women and Native Americans. They got rights later. They would have wanted that. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness was one of the things that the Founding Fathers wanted. I feel that it is described as being happy, healthy, and being free to do lawful things whenever you want. I feel like I have those rights, and I think most other people do too. In the past, many ethnic groups weren't given those things. The African American community wasn't fully given those rights until Martin Luther King Jr. protested for them. The same thing happened with women, immigrants, and Native Americans. Our country definitely isn't perfect, but I think that it is what the Founding Fathers would have envisioned. We have put many of their ideas into place and maintain their good practices.
Richard Johnson, thank you for your service.
Bill Martinson, thank you for your service.
This is Fernando B. Gomez. He was in the Marines, and thank you for your service.
Private First Class Foster Bridger Sr., Sergeant Anthony Nielsen, thank you for your service.
Arlen Carlson, thank you for your service.